House Escher is well known for its all-female gangs that make extensive use of poisons and toxins to defeat their enemies. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint one of these gangers in the colour scheme of the Carrion Queens, which is the colour scheme you can see on the Necromunda Underhive box. Now, these miniatures have loads of detail and character to them, so I'm really looking forward to painting one. So, without further ado, let's get started. Whilst in this video we're going to run you through the entire process of painting your House Escher Ganger, we are actually going to be using a number of colour swatches that appear in the Citadel Paint app. So if you haven't downloaded it already, you might want to for useful reference throughout this video. Specifically, we're going to be using gunmetal, medium flesh, and also a slight variation on yellow. So you can see it's just handy reference to have. Now, yellow is the first area of colour we're going to be painting in, but before we do start painting any yellow on, you need to undercoat your miniatures. And we recommend you use Mechanica Standard Grey Spray for these, which you can see is exactly what we've done for our miniature here. Now, the first paint we need is Avalan Sunset, and as always, remember to give all your paints a really good shake before you use each colour. Now, I'm going to be applying this using a medium layer brush. It's a really good size for the kind of detail we want to paint now. But what I recommend you do, and you'll see this throughout the video, we really recommend you use a palette to control your paints. Just get some of the paint like that and put it onto your palette so you've got a good little dollop there, and then add some water to it. Now, this is really important because doing this allows you to control your paints much more easily. It also means they go a little bit further and they'll dry smoother as well. You want them to be about that sort of consistency before you apply them, and you need to make sure you haven't overloaded your brush either. So you can just twist it like this to get rid of the excess paint. So the kind of area we're looking to paint in now is the armour, and it's mostly in the form of this armoured jacket that she's wearing. So you just need to paint in areas such as this. You also need to paint around the collar, and on the back of the body there's also some more armour here, so you need to paint all this too. If you can still see some of that Mechanica Standard Grey undercoat showing through as you apply this, then don't worry about it, just let this coat dry and apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. Once you've finished blocking in that yellow detail, we're ready to move on to the next colour, which is going to be a Abaddon Black for all the black detail. And there's quite a lot of this, but first of all we need to get our paint ready. So we're going to use the medium layer brush once again, and as before, use your palette to get that paint ready by putting a small amount on your palette there like that, then adding a little bit of water to the mix so it's nice and smooth. Now, whilst I'm using a medium layer brush for most of this, you might want to have a small airbrush on hand as well for some of the finer details, which you'll see in a moment. But once that paint is ready, make sure your brush isn't overloaded, and then we're ready to start blocking these details in. So first of all, we want to paint things like the trousers down here, going all the way up to the waist around there. But you also want to paint in the black leather. So you're looking at areas such as her belt for this detail just there. And there's also some leather going around her forearms, so be sure to catch those parts too. And there's also the body of the lasgun. So you're looking at this kind of area just around here. Now this miniature is also wearing an eye patch and has a collar, so we need to paint those parts in too. And this is where you might need the small layer brush. There's some black trim going around her armour as well. So for this part, you're just looking for the raised lips, such as just along there. You just want to carefully follow along like that. If you do make any mistakes with this part, then just go back to Avalan Sunset to neaten up before you continue. Now that we've base coated all those details in black, we can move on to the next paint. Now this is going to be Dark Reaper, and we're going to be painting this again on the legs. This time still with a medium layer brush, and well, as before, use your palette. But this time we want to thin the paint down a little bit more than we have been doing. So just slightly more water. We're looking to get to about that kind of point there before we start to apply it. So once you've got it loaded on your brush, you're just looking to pick out the legs. And we're looking to go up to this point just here and then work your way down, avoiding the black strap that we've got for the knee pad, which goes just around the back there, and then carrying on all the way down to the feet. Once you've finished with Dark Reaper, we can move on to the next colour, and in fact the next few colours all use the same technique to apply, so we're going to run through those quickly for you now. First of all, we need Balthazar Gold, and this will be for the grip of her stiletto dagger, but also any decorative elements you can find as well. Then we'll move on to Lead Belcher for all the silver details like you get on her lasgun, followed by Doomball Brown for both the warm leather but also the stock on her gun. After that we're going to need XV88, and this is going to be to paint the pelt around her waist. But we need to start out with Balthazar Gold, which I'm going to be applying still with my medium layer brush, again using that palette to get the paint ready. So a little bit of water mixed in there like that, and then we're ready to start applying it. And like I said, the details we're looking for here are the grip of her dagger, such as just round here, but also little decorative elements such as the belt buckle, and be really careful as you paint this one in. Next, we need lead belcher for all the silver details, and there's quite a few of these. You want to do things such as the shoulder armor we've got round here, but also, of course, the blade of the dagger, any spikes you can find on the miniature. There's also some details on the belt, such as these things here, but we've also got grenades to do as well. And also, we want to paint some details on her lasgun. And for this, you're looking at details such as the clip and all these parts that we've got around the trigger here. We're now ready to add some Doomball Brown to the miniature, and this is for the warm leather that we've got on this strap running down here. But also at this point, be sure to paint in the wooden stock of the lasgun as well. And finally, using XV88, paint in the pelt around the waist. Once you've finished blocking in all those colours, you're then ready to add some shade to the miniature to really give it some depth and to start to bring all those colours together. We're going to use Norm Oil for this miniature, and I'm going to be applying it using a medium shade brush. It's an excellent size for the kind of area we want to cover here. And what you need to do is just get some of your shade onto your palette like this so that you can control exactly how much you're applying at once. And we do want to be applying quite a lot at once, so make sure you load up a good amount on your brush. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do here is to paint it all over the miniature. And you'll see it settles really quickly and all those recessed details, and you can see it there, just starting to give the model that depth and to bring those details out as well. Now, once you've finished applying this all over the miniature, give it plenty of time to dry. About 40 minutes will be good for a miniature this size. And as it's drying, just keep an eye on it because the shade will tend to pull towards the bottom of the miniature. If you see a large amount gathering around the feet, such as just there, just use your brush to move away the excess paint before it's dried. Now that second coat's completely dry as well, you can see just what a difference that shade has made to the miniature. It's given it loads of depth, but it has darkened it down quite a bit. So what we need to do now is just brighten up some of these colours before we move on. First of all, we're going to go back to the yellow details, but this time we're going to apply some Uriel yellow to them. But for the pelts, we're going to go back to XV88 to make that part brighter. But we need to start out with Uriel yellow, and this time I'm going to be applying it with my small layer brush. And what we want to do is again use the palette to get the paint ready, but this time we're looking for a lot of control here because there's specific bits we want to paint with this color. So use your palette to make sure your brush isn't overloaded, and when you're ready, what you want to do here is to apply this over the yellow details, but not all of them this time. You're looking for areas where shade settled and you want to avoid those parts. So a great example is this ridged arm we've got on the back here. What I'll do is apply this yellow to the flat panel just here. But you can see beneath it, we've got some shade that's settled in that recess just there. So I want to miss that bit and paint the yellow a little distance from it there like that, because this way we keep that definition from the shade. So it's just a matter of taking your time doing this over the yellow now, and you will need to apply two thin coats on this point. Then repeat this process with XV88 on the pelt, and this time, because we're painting fabric, we're looking for the recesses of the creases. So for example, you can see I've just picked out a raised part of one just there. I'd avoid the recess where it's shaded directly beneath it, and then carry on just down here like this. Now that we've finished brightening up those colours, we can move on to the next feature of the miniature, which is quite a big one, because now we need to paint in the skin and the hair. Now to do this, we're going to start out with the skin, for which we're going to apply a base coat of Bugman's Glow. And I'm going to be applying this mostly with my medium layer brush, but I do have that small layer brush on hand, because you will need it for this. A lot of these features are very fine, and some are quite tricky to get to. So to help with that, you again need to use your palette to make sure your paint is thinned down and flowing really smoothly. And once you've got it ready to about that kind of point there, all you need to do is start blocking in this colour. Now really take your time on this stage because, like I said, the detail is quite fine and some is quite tricky to get to. So just be patient, take your time and be as neat as you can. And remember to apply a second thin coat if you can still see some colours showing through. Now the skin's blocked in, we're ready to start painting her hair. And for this, we're going to be using Troll Slayer Orange. Now, this is quite a thin paint, so you will need to do multiple coats here. You'll certainly need to do two, possibly even three. But still, be sure to use your palette to get your paint ready. I'm still using my medium layer brush for this. And as you apply this, you just need to be careful of her head now. So just really take your time as you get down to the bottom of the hair like this. But you can see there just how thin this colour is. Don't be tempted to put on loads at once. Remember to keep it thin so that you get a smooth result in the end. Continue building up that Troll Slayer Orange until you reach this point, and once you've done so, you're then ready to shade both the skin and the hair at the same time using Reichlin Flesh Shade. Now this time we're going to be applying the shade with the medium layer brush, and because we've got to be careful here not to put on too much at once. You don't want to get it onto details that we've finished painting so far, so you must make sure you don't overload your brush on your palette. But once you have got some on your brush there like that, what you're looking to do is to apply this to the skin and the hair as neatly as you can so that you don't get it onto those other features. Once that shade is completely dry, we're then ready to go back to the skin to start to layer it to really brighten it up. And for this, we're going to use Cadian Flesh Tone applied to the small layer brush. And we need to be quite selective here about which bits exactly we paint. We want to really bring out the features of the face and the skin and really enhance them. So to do this, again, use your palette to make sure your brush isn't overloaded. Make sure that paint is flowing smoothly. And what we're looking to do is, I'll go on the face here to show you exactly what I mean. We're looking to pick out those main features. So for example, we start in the center here with the nose, just picking it out like that. Then we have the top lip just there, avoiding that recess of the mouth there, picking out the bottom lip, and then carrying on down to the chin. So all the time, I'm avoiding those recesses where more shade has settled. And the same will be true then as you go up onto the cheekbone there like that. Now onto the muscles and the rest of the body, the same thing is true. You just apply this over most of it, but avoid those recessed areas where you've got more shade. So for example, we've just got a little recess just there on the belly, so I'll avoid that and carry on just there. Once you've finished building up that layer, you're then ready to move on to highlight the skin. And for this, we need Kislev Flesh, still applied to the small layer brush. And what we're looking to do now is be much more precise about where exactly we paint this on. So still use your palette and thin it down with a little bit of water. But the trick here is to make sure you have a fine tip on your brush so that you have lots of control over the paint. So just twist your brush and drag it along like this. And then when you've got that fine tip, you're ready to start picking out the finest features on the flesh. So the face is a great example of this. What we're looking to do is pick out the features such as the nose just down the center. Then we've got the top lip to do as well, just across there. We also need to pick out the chin, and you'll want to carry on doing the cheekbones, the brow, the ears, all this kind of thing. Now, when it comes to the muscles and the body, what you want to do is just think about where light would catch and then follow along those areas. So for example, we've just got the hip just along here, and just follow that there like that. And once you've finished applying those highlights to the skin, you're then ready to highlight her hair. Now for this, we need Fire Dragon Bright, and we're going to be applying it again with a small layer brush. And what we want to do is to pick out the raised strands of the hair. So again, use your palette to get your paint ready so it's flowing smoothly. And once you got it to this point, you're ready to start picking these details out. So what you need to do is just keep your hands as steady as possible, and you're looking to follow these strands, such as this one just here, going all the way down. And with that, both the hair and the skin are complete, and we can now begin highlighting all those remaining details on the miniature. First of all, we're going to highlight all the yellow detail using a technique called edge highlighting, and the paint we need is Flash Kit's Yellow. Now to do this, you again need your small layer brush, and the trick here is to essentially highlight all the edges and all the detail that you can find. So as before, use your palette to get your paint ready so you can pick these details out easily. A little bit of water mixed in there like that, perhaps a little bit more paint. There we go. And then what we're looking for is, edges, such as on the back of the armour we've got just here. See these sharp edges we've got? I just want to follow along with these as neatly as I can, with as fine a line as possible, like that, just to really emphasise those details. Once you've finished applying that edge highlight, all the yellow detail is complete, and we can move on to the next detail, which is going to be to paint her legs. Now for this, we need Thunderhawk Blue, which again we're going to edge highlight with, so still use your small layer brush to apply this. And as before, you want to use your palette to get that paint flowing really smoothly, but also, really importantly, that fine tip on your brush. So once you've done that, the kind of thing you're looking for is sharper edges, but also any sharper features on these details. Now you can see she's actually wearing boots that go right up to here, so what we need to do is just paint the top of them with a line of this colour, just running along there like that, and then follow that stitching just down the back there like that. Now you're also looking for any sharper creases and features, so great examples of this are her ankle, so just down there. And we've also got the back of her calf, so you just want to pick that out just there like that. Once you've finished applying that highlight, those features on the legs are complete, and actually what we need to do now is carry on highlighting all those remaining colours using much the same technique. So we're going to run through those quickly for you now. First of all, we need Psychorax Bronze to highlight all the bronze details, followed by Stormhost Silver for all the silver details. Then we need Tuskor Fur, and this will be for the gunstock and the warm leather, and then we need Eschen Grey for all the remaining black details. After that, we just need to paint in the pelt, and for this, we need Taillight Ochre first of all, followed by Abaddon Black for the patterns on it. But first of all, we need Psychorax Bronze applied again with that small layer brush, and what we want to do is again use that palette to get your paint ready so it's flowing really smoothly. You want it about this kind of consistency, and once you've got that, you just need to start picking out the edges of all the bronze details. So on the dagger just here, what I'm going to do is just run my brush very lightly across that corner to get a sharp highlight just like that. Next, we're ready to highlight all the silver details using Stormhost Silver following the same technique. So as neatly as you can, just follow along all the sharp edges of these details. Now at this point as well, if your miniature has any gems on it, such as the belt buckle down here, apply a coat of this to the middle of them, just here to prepare it for later on. The next highlight to apply is with tusk or fur, and this is for all the red leather and also for the stock on the lasgun as well. And as before, just follow along all the sharpest edges and details. With those highlights applied, we can now move on to Eschen Grey, and this is to highlight all the remaining black details that we've not yet highlighted so far. We're now ready to move on to painting the pelt, and for this, first of all, we need Tau Light Ochre applied along all the edges and the tops of the creases as well. And finally, add the patterns to the pelt with a Baden Black by just applying it as little small squiggly lines. With all those highlights applied and the pelt complete, we now just have one more detail left to paint in to finish the miniature, and that is the gem on the belt buckle. Now remember, earlier on we prepared this by applying a layer of Stormhost Silver over it, and to complete it what we need now is Soulstone Blue. Now this paint's a little bit different from all the other paints we've been using. You don't need to use your palette for it, and you don't need to thin it down with any water. Instead, what you do is just use a small layer brush to get a little dollop of it on the end of the bristles like that, and then on the gem, you apply this dollop to the bottom left-hand corner of it, so just there, and then pull all of it up to the top right. So you're leaving a trace of that blue behind, but having more of the colour on the top right there like that to get a cool gem effect. And once you've done this, all you've got to do is base your miniature, and I recommend you base your entire gang in the same way. And with the base fully painted, this House Escher Ganger is complete, ready to do battle in the Underhive against rival gangs for power and glory. So when you're painting your House Escher Ganger, we always recommend that you use a palette to control your paints. Doing this is really important, especially on miniatures like this where there's a lot of fine detail. Now when you're applying the paints to your miniature, be sure to apply them as multiple thin coats, because doing so ensures a smooth finish, especially with those yellows. And finally, remember that neatness is the key. The neater you are, the better the final result is going to be. So we really hope you've enjoyed this video, and we really hope you enjoy painting your gang as well. So have fun with them, and have fun playing with them too, and we'll see you all again very soon.